Hello everyone. So now we are here in the new section of our anatomy, that is the blood supply in our whole body. So what are the branches and arteries actually? So firstly we have to know the largest artery actually, which actually from where the all branches in our body actually originates. So the largest branch of our body, largest artery that takes the blood from the heart to the rest part of our body, that is oxygenated blood. So that artery is actually aorta. So aorta is actually originates from the left ventricle of our heart, from the base of the left ventricle, from the and aorta has four sections actually. First one is your ascending aorta, second one is your arc of aorta, and third one is your descending aorta. And descending aorta is actually, you can say, is at thoracic aorta also, and further when it goes inside the abdominal part, so there it is called as abdominal aorta. So there are four sections of aorta. So let's see what are the branches and main, actually the main artery from where the blood supply goes to whole or lower part and the upper part of our body. So this is the main section, main part of our origin of our blood supply. So let's begin from the heart. So this is your thoracic section. This is the overview of our human body, and this is your abdominal part. So this is the heart. And from the base of the left ventricle actually, the ascending aorta arises. So from here, consider your ascending aorta arises. This is your ascending aorta. So it is the widest part of aorta, that is, it is the widest part of aorta, 3 cm widest. So first section of our aorta is ascending aorta, and let's see what are the branches it actually gives. It originates from our base of the left ventricle, and its level, according to the topography, if you see, it actually originates at the level of your third left costal cartilage. So this is your ascending aorta. And ascending aorta, from the origin, it actually gives a branch, two branches, that is to the heart. Ascending aorta is basically meant for the blood supply to our heart. So heart also needs blood supply. So the aorta's ascending part actually gives the blood supply by the branches called as right and left coronary arteries. So these branches actually originates from where the ascending aorta originates. So from there only the branches leaves inside the heart. So for in the side you can here you can show it as inside, you can show left and right coronary artery. So this and this is your right and left coronary arteries. So ascending aorta is actually concerned with only blood supply to our heart. So is only 3 cm wide. So from the where the ascending aorta ends, actually the region where the ascending aorta ends, from there actually begins our arc of aorta. Arc of aorta goes little bit superior and then obliquely curves and goes downward. And arc of aorta is actually begins it actually begins the arc of aorta is the level, you can say it as here, and it begins at the level of your right second sternocostal joint. So this is your arc of aorta, and it actually originates from the right second sternocostal joint. And further, the pathway, as it goes further, it actually goes posterior to the left root of the lung and reaches the T4 vertebra, where it ends actually. So at the level of T4 vertebra, you can say it as at the level of T4 vertebra, it actually ends here. Consider it as here. So this is the level where your arc of aorta ends. So and where it ends actually, there is the beginning. Now the thoracic aorta begins from here. So this was your arc of aorta. Let's see what are the branches actually. Further we will see discuss about thoracic aorta. So first actually from the where the arc of aorta begins, there arises a branch to the right side of our body, they are one branch that is called as brachiocephalic trunk. So brachiocephalic trunk goes further, and brachiocephalic trunk divides into two branches actually. First one is your common carotid artery, and it actually divides at the level of your sternocostal joint, right? Sternoclavicular actually. So consider it as your clavicle. So this is your clavicle bone. So at the level of here only, at the level here, it actually divides into two branches. This is your brachiocephalic trunk. It's not too long, but this is your brachiocephalic trunk. And at the level of your right sternoclavicular joint, it divides into two branches. One branch goes to the right part of our, that is the right hand or axillary branch, and one part goes to the, this is your subclavian, right subclavian artery, we see it as light. It goes beneath the clavicle bone, and further it goes inside the arm through the axillary region. And another branch is actually your common carotid artery. So this is your common carotid artery, and this is your right common, you can say, because it is right side. So, and right subclavian artery. So these are the main actually branches, which further gives branches to our left hand, actually the left arm of our body, right arm of our body. And the right side, right common carotid actually bifurcates further at the level of your C4 cervical vertebra, and the level of your laryngeal thyroid cartilage. It further divides into two branches in the form of your internal carotid artery and external carotid artery. So further we will specific discuss about these arteries, what are the branches, further internal and external carotid, in the next videos. So this was actually the main how the arteries are arranged in our body. And so this was the right side. So just 2 centimeter forward for the left side the branch arises, but here is a change. There is no brachiocephalic trunk in the left side. There's a direct branch for our left subclavian artery, and this is your left subclavian artery. And same as from here, your common carotid artery arises for the left side of your blood supply of your head and neck. So it is same as the right side, and left subclavian artery actually is, it is at the level of your left sternoclavicular joint. So this was the same pathway, and this is your arc of aorta. And from where it actually ends, now this was your subclavian artery, left subclavian artery, and this was the ending of your arc of aorta. From here actually begins, and the ending actually occurs at the level of your T4 vertebra, from where begins your descending aorta, or you can say it as thoracic aorta. So from T4 level to your T12 level, actually till the level here, this branch is your descending aorta, or you can say it as thoracic aorta. Descending aorta is further two parts. In the thoracic region it is said as thoracic aorta, and the abdomen it is called as abdominal aorta. So this is thoracic aorta. So T4 to T12 level, actually this is your T12 level. So this is the topography of actually descending aorta. It originates at the level of your T4 vertebra, and it goes to the left of your vertebral column, actually left of the vertebral column it actually goes, and end at the T12 vertebra. T12 vertebra and begins your descending aorta, and at T12 vertebra, lower border of actually of T12 vertebra. So this was actually your descending aorta, and here is your, in the diaphragm there is an aortic orifice from where it actually inserts inside the diaphragm. This is your diaphragm. Before you enter in the abdominal cavity, there is a muscular layer which is called as diaphragm for the visceral organs protection of. So there is an aortic orifice. This is called as aortic orifice, from which your descending aorta goes inside the abdominal cavity. So after entering, it is now said as abdominal aorta inside your abdomen. So we have not discussed about the branches of our descending aorta. So descending aorta actually has, so we will not write here, we will write separately here about the branches of descending aorta. So descending aorta has two, divided into two types of branches, or thoracic aorta you can say, thoracic aorta. And first one is your parietal branch, and second one is your visceral branch. So what are included in both, we will write here. Parietal includes subcostal arteries, intercostal artery, and your superior phrenic artery. So this is superior, and the visceral branch actually includes your pericardial branch, esophageal branch, mediastinal branch, and your mediastinal branch, and your brachial branch also, bronchial branch. So this was the branch which gives to the at the level of your descending aorta. And with respect to mediastinum, if we say that, so we can say that ascending aorta is present inside your inferior mediastinum. Ascending aorta is an inferior mediastinum, and your arc of aorta is inside superior mediastinum, and your posterior, not your posterior, your thoracic aorta, that is your descending aorta, is inside your posterior mediastinum. So thoracic aorta in the posterior mediastinum. So this was actually the branches at the level of your descending aorta. So from at the level of T12 vertebra, your beginning of your abdominal aorta. So this is your abdominal aorta, and abdominal aorta actually goes anterior and left to the left of your vertebral column. So this is the topography of actually abdominal aorta. So it is also further many branches, because it actually supplies your visceral organs, visceral region. And now what is the ending? Firstly discuss about the terminal branch of actually the abdominal aorta. So it actually ends at the level of your, it begins at the level of your T12 and ends at the level of your lumbar, L4. L4 in the form of your common iliac artery, right and left. So this is your right and this is your left, common iliac, and your right, common iliac. So this is your, actually this bifurcation is your at the level of your L4, and it actually goes to the anterior and the left of your vertebral column, so left side. So let's now see the branches actually of abdominal aorta. It has also many branches according to the groups, because from the anterior side some branches arises from the lateral side of this abdominal aorta, some branches arise from the posterior or the dorsal side, and two terminal branches. So terminal branches we have discussed, so we have three groups now. So this is your abdominal aorta, and it has four divisions. First one is your anterior group, anterior group. So anterior group has branches, celiac trunk, and superior mesenteric artery, inferior mesenteric artery, or second one is your lateral group. Lateral group has, first one is your suprarenal, by the name it is clear that it goes to the kidney, and second one is your specific suprarenal, actually goes to your adrenal gland. Renal artery actually goes to your kidney. Gonadal artery for the gonads, reproductive organs, gonadal artery. So these are the three branches, and now third one is your dorsal group. Dorsal group, posterior or dorsal you can say. So first one is your inferior phrenic artery. Second one is your lumbar artery. These arises from your posterior sides, and median sacral artery for the sacral region. And this common iliac actually further give branches leg and the pelvic region. There it give branches for the blood supply, and two terminal branches. You can write it here. Terminal branches. You can write it here. Terminal branches. So these are right and left common iliac artery. So later on we will discuss in the specific part, what in the specific videos, abdominal artery. These are only names now, right now only just learn the names. Further we will discuss what is superior, what are the branches of superior mesenteric and suprarenal renal arteries. Further what they supply inside the organ, which region of the visceral organs. So and this also is descending aorta also. So this was actually the scheme of your how your human body, actually the blood supply starts, originates. So the main center is your heart, from where the abdominal from where the aorta actually takes the blood, oxygenated blood, and supply to the rest part of your body. And these are the branches which actually from the common carotid you supply to your head and neck, from subclavian artery you supplies to your arms from the left and right side, and in the thoracic region you actually supplies the esophagus and all the region, all the organs which are present in the thoracic part. In the abdominal region you actually supplies your visceral organs, and further where the abdominal aorta ends, there it gives terminal branches, common iliac artery, which further supplies your lower part of the body, pelvic, and the leg region. So this was actually the scheme of your aorta. Thank you.